Even though Windows Sandbox is one of my favorite features in Windows, I'll explain why later if you're not familiar, it does have some annoying limitations, like not including the Microsoft Store, which means you can't even use basic apps like Notepad that are installed through that. You heard that right. The Windows Sandbox does not have Notepad in it by default. And up until now, Microsoft has been saying that it's just not possible to install the Microsoft Store in the Sandbox. But spoiler, they are wrong, and I created a PowerShell script that installs it from scratch by fetching the necessary download files from Microsoft's update servers. Of course, I'll put the link to it below. It's just on my GitHub repo where I also have other useful scripts for Sandbox too. I'll explain how the script works in a second, but if you're not familiar with the Windows Sandbox, here's a quick rundown. Basically, it opens a temporary fresh instance of Windows every time you run it with nothing in it that's isolated from your main system, and then when you close it, poof, it's all gone. So if there's some app that you think you can trust but you're not really sure, you can run it in there. Or if there's some program that you know you're only gonna need to run real quick for one thing, you can just install it in the Sandbox, do what you need to do without cluttering up your main system. Or maybe I want to check if a program has a feature I need or can even do what I need before actually installing it on my main system. It's also good for testing out different commands that you're not really sure what they might do or are worried that you'll do it wrong and mess things up. You can test it out in the Sandbox first. And because it's basically the equivalent of a fresh install of Windows every time, if Windows or some program is acting weird, you can test out to see if that weird behavior still happens within the Sandbox to know whether it's some other program on your main computer messing with it or if it just is like that. Now, Windows Sandbox is only available in the Windows 10 and 11 Pro Edition and higher. It's not in Home Edition, but I would actually say that this feature alone is worth the extra price to upgrade to the Pro Edition. Anyway, going back to making the Windows Sandbox more useful, I did not actually stop at just the Microsoft Store installer script. I have a bunch of other scripts and useful stuff in that same GitHub repository that I mentioned before. For example, there's a script that installs Winget, that package manager that's normally built into Windows, and makes it easy to install a bunch of software via the command line, as well as a couple scripts for quickly changing the Windows theme in the Sandbox from dark mode to light mode so you're not blinded at night. And I even made a startup script that runs anytime I launch the Sandbox and sets a bunch of Windows preferences to my liking, including enable showing file extensions and hidden files, as well as enabling the old context menu, adding options to open PowerShell and command prompt to the current directory in the context menu, and more. For getting the startup script to automatically run, I have another Windows Sandbox configuration file, they're called. And those in general just let you customize different stuff about the Sandbox before it runs, like how much RAM you're gonna allocate to it. And importantly, it also allows you to mount real folders on your main computer into the Sandbox so they're accessible. And also in the configuration, you can set a command that will be run when it launches. So basically you put the startup script into the mapped folder and then use the startup command to run that startup script from within the Sandbox when it launches. I personally like to put some other tools and stuff in this folder, like a copy of Notepad and Notepad++. And then I even have the startup script, so it default associates text files with one of those. But you can always add more to the script. That's just how I have it set up. Now, going back to the Microsoft Store installer script, I said I would explain how it works. And it basically uses the Windows Update APIs with a little bit of reverse engineering. But right off the bat, I'll say that it does not use any third-party APIs at all. It literally does everything directly through Microsoft. You just run it from within the Sandbox, and then it sends a request to the Update API to get the list of packages associated with the Microsoft Store, and then it sends back a list of all the different package names, and then you also send back another request to request the download URLs for those, and then once it responds with those, it downloads and installs them. Because if you weren't aware, the thing about the Windows Update API is there's no static, unchanging file URLs that you can get. It generates a URL that's good for like 24 hours and then it stops working. So it's not as simple as just having a script that downloads from a couple links. You have to actually send a request and do some stuff with it for it to work. And that's what the script does. And once it's done, the Microsoft Store will just be installed. You can see it from the start menu and it works just as you'd expect. And you can even go and search for apps like Notepad and install it as you normally would. And as far as I know, it should work for everything else. So if you already were using the Windows Sandbox, hopefully now it's even more useful. Or if you just learned about it, you can really hit the ground running. So do let me know if you find it helpful. And of course, if you enjoyed the video, you know what to do. Absolutely smash and annihilate the like button into oblivion. It really helps out. If you want to keep watching, the next video I recommend is where I talked about how I made Windows Explorer better with a thumbnail extension that you might not be aware of. I'll put that link right there you can click on. And if you want to subscribe, I make videos about twice a week, usually Wednesday and Saturday, so it should be worth it. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.